Canadian-based exploration company Darnley Bay is focused on a monster project in the Canadian Arctic. Joining me from the company is Chairman Kerry Knoll. Kerry, thank you for being here.
Thank you.
So tell me about the asset.
It is something called a gravity anomaly, and it's right up on the Arctic coast, not that far from Inuvic, near the Beaufort Sea, where they've discovered a lot of oil and gas, although this is on land. And this is an anomaly in terms of its size. It's a very, very unusual anomaly. It's about 100 kilometers by 80 kilometers, if you can just picture that size. And it is not only large, but strong. If you compare it with other mining areas in Canada, for example, it is about five times as strong as the Sudbury Camp, which has hosted dozens of nickel mines. It's about eight times as strong as Olympic Dam in Australia, which is the largest ore body in the world. But no one knows what it is. It's this anomaly that was discovered literally by an Inco geologist who flew over it in the 1950s, and the airplane's controls all went wonky. Is there something making that happen, some kind of metal, but no one knows what kind of metal? People have a lot of theories. A lot of academics have written papers and theories on what this is, but no one knows what it is.
So what is a gravity anomaly?
Gravity anomaly is simply, to be put very simply, it is something that is measured in milligals. Milligal is a millionth of a Galileo, and that's the unit of pull that the Earth's gravity has. But unbeknownst to me, before I got into mining, was that a gravity anomaly means that in a particular spot, the Earth's pull is slightly stronger, and being stronger in a particular area is usually the result of a large mass down below the surface. Metal does that. So what kind of metal, we don't know. Is it something that's valuable? We don't know. But it's something that's very large and very massive.
You had a press release out a few weeks back about a change in management. Can you explain that?
Well, I had been on the board of Darnley Bay for several years, taking but not a very active role. And as the company was stalled, it wasn't really getting anywhere, so I went on a search for a new president, and the previous president had resigned recently, and I then went to the board and suggested I use my expertise in the mining business as chairman of the company. So I've come on as chairman, and a fellow by the name of Jamie Levy has come on as the new president.
And I understand you've recently undergone a financing.
Yes. We had a property payment due. This property is owned, this anomaly is owned by the natives. They were owed some money. They've been paid millions of dollars so far, and there was one last property payment to be due. So we raised $740,000 to do that, make that payment, pay a few other bills. Our next step is to raise additional money to drill and find out what this anomaly is.
And what can we watch for in the next year? 2013.
Well, if we're successful in raising money, and I think we will be in my career with various companies I've been with, I've raised about $1.3 billion, and we're probably only looking for about $5 million to drill this property. So we intend to do that over the next several months, and at that point, mobilize a crew, get our drilling permits, get the drill up there, and find out what the big mystery is.
And I understand you have quite an extensive history. Can you touch on that a little bit for us?
Yeah, I've been in mining for about 30 years, and in that time started five mining companies. Four of them have built mines successfully and gone into production, and the fifth one is in the process of doing that now. So that's kind of where most of my experience in mining has been, in building mines. This is an unusual thing for me, but it's such an interesting anomaly that I couldn't help but getting involved.
Can't resist. Thank you very much for your time. Thanks for being here.
Well, thanks for having me on the show.
Kerry Knoll, Chairman of Darnley Bay.